welcome to A Taste of Old Colony History, where we try out historic recipes and local favorites right here in our home kitchens. On today's episode, we're making New England clam chowder and pairing it with common crackers. Let's get cooking. For our common crackers recipe, these are the tools and ingredients we will need: all-purpose flour, salt, sugar, baking powder, butter, and heavy cream. And for tools, we'll need a food processor to blend all our ingredients together, a tablespoon, a teaspoon, and a 3/4 teaspoon measure, a 1 cup measure, dry and wet, and then a knife to chop up our butter, and then plastic wrap for when we store the dough for the crackers in the refrigerator for 30 minutes. After the dough chills, we'll need some other tools, and I'll show you those when we get to that step. So first we're gonna get our dry ingredients together into our food processor. Mine happens to be a blender. And we need 4 cups of all-purpose flour. We need 2 teaspoons of sugar. Tablespoon of salt, 3/4 teaspoons of baking powder. Just gonna give those a quick pulse just to get those mixed together. So our next step, we're gonna chop our butter into 1/2-inch cubes, whole stick of butter. Now we're gonna pulse this until a coarse meal starts to form. Just trying to make sure everything doesn't settle on the bottom. That looks like a nice coarse meal to me. That's what it feels like. So we're ready for our final ingredient, which is 1 cup of heavy cream. We want a stiff dough to start to form. But it does. Forming a nice dough. Just want to make sure everything gets well combined. We definitely have some dry flour down there at the bottom. Okay, so we did a little quick change. The blender that I was using was not a good alternative for a food processor for this recipe. Sometimes it is, and that's why I tried to use it. But the shape of it didn't allow for everything to combine together. So we transferred it into my mixing bowl. I'm gonna attach my dough hook and see if we can get this to come together a little bit better with the dough hook. Give it a few minutes and we'll see how it goes. So when I squish this together, it stays. So I'm gonna use the bowl to my advantage, squish it all together, and then we will turn this out onto a piece of plastic wrap. We'll get it flattened out into a disc, and then it will chill in the refrigerator for 30 minutes. So I got it in plastic wrap, and I'm using the plastic wrap to help me like form it into a ball. Really dry, which makes sense for the crackers because they are a pretty dry little plain cracker, but we'll see how these turn out. So this little ball will go into the refrigerator for 30 minutes. So it's time to roll, cut, and bake our common crackers. The dough has been in the fridge for 30 minutes. It seems to have firmed up a bit more, so hopefully it'll be what we need. For this step, you'll need a rolling pin. We're gonna flour this surface. We need a baking sheet with some parchment to line it. You'll need a biscuit cutter. I'm using the top of a mason jar. This is about the size that you want. This is a smallmouth mason jar. And then you'll need a little brush, because we're gonna brush the tops of our crackers with a little bit more cream before they bake. And we're gonna preheat our oven to 400 degrees now. Set all these tools aside while we roll out our dough. You know this, if you've seen episodes of the show before, you know how dough and I go. So I'm gonna flour this countertop here, and we're gonna see how this turns out. Flour everything. So the recipe wants this to be 3/8 of an inch thick. Just gonna get it as thin as I can. See how many little circles I can get out of this guy. Lay them out on my baking sheet. You can see as I'm pulling the dough away, the lamination in it, you can already see it. So they should puff up and be pretty tasty. So our last step before the crackers go in the oven is to brush the tops with a little bit of heavy cream. These go in the oven for 15 to 17 minutes, and then we'll take them and put them on the wire rack to cool. So I'm gonna pop them in the oven. We just got to 400 degrees. So we'll check on them in 15, make sure they're golden, and then we'll let them cool. So we're gonna check on our crackers after 15 minutes, and then we will get started on our chowder while they bake. These are the tools and ingredients we will need to make our New England clam chowder. So in our large pot, we have 7 pounds of little neck clams that have been scrubbed and rinsed. We have 3 cups of water measured out that we're gonna use to boil those clams. We'll also need bacon, a Spanish onion, flour, large red potatoes, fresh thyme, fresh parsley, and heavy cream. So to chop everything up, we have our cutting board and a knife. I have a tablespoon measure, a wet measuring cup, a slotted spoon. And then as we strain our broth, you'll need another bowl to contain it in and some sort of strainer that we will line. You can use either a coffee filter or I will use a paper towel. The first step after the clams have been scrubbed and rinsed is to get them into a pot, add 3 cups of water. We're gonna cover this and boil it for 10 minutes. So it's gonna have to come up to a boil and then 10 minutes. While the clams boil and steam open, I'm gonna prep everything else so it's ready for us when we get to those steps. So we're gonna chop our potatoes, chop up our onion. We need 4 slices of this bacon that we're gonna chop up. So do a little of that and then hopefully our clams will be ready. Large red potatoes diced. Next, our onion. So, our common crackers have been in the oven for 19 minutes and they look pretty great. Got golden on the top, they have that nice sheen from brushing them with the cream. Nice and crispy. I'm gonna pop these onto a wire rack and allow them to cool. Doing a check-in on our clams. Some of them are just starting to open. The water is not quite boiling. So we're gonna let them do their thing. And as these clams begin to open, we're gonna finish prepping all our other ingredients. Okay, so the clams are done. I turned off the heat. They're definitely boiling. A ton of them are wide open. So our next step is we're gonna remove these from the water. I'm gonna
strain the broth that they've created. First, I'm gonna take them out. I'm gonna discard any that didn't open. That's a really important step. You don't wanna eat those ones. And then I'll do the next step where we strain the broth. All right, so I'm now sorting through the clams. I'm just taking them out and making sure everybody opened, transferring them into a different bowl. Our next step is to strain this broth because we want to keep this. We're going to save this and use it. So I only have my teeny tiny fine mesh strainer. So I have lined my strainer with a paper towel because I don't have any paper coffee filters, but that would be a great thing you could use. And I'm just going to slowly pour our broth through the strainer, catch any sand or little bits. We're gonna set this broth aside, get rid of our strainer. You can see some little bits that it caught in there. Set this aside, we're gonna wash this pot out and then use it again for all our other ingredients and to actually make the chowder. All right, so we're on to our next step of prepping our chowder. Our pot is clean, I've got the heat on. We're gonna let this get a little hot before we add in our bacon. We're gonna saute that, render some fat down, and while the bacon cooks, we're gonna get our herbs ready to chop. We need a teaspoon of fresh thyme, and then a tablespoon or 2 tablespoons of chopped fresh parsley. I probably have a little extra thyme that I need here. All right, so we're gonna get our bacon going. Get some really nice salt and fat from this bacon. Some nice smoky flavor. Bacon's really nice and brown. Fat's all rendered down, so we're gonna take it out with our slotted spoon. Leave the heat on. So next up is our onion. Let that onion get nice and translucent. Onions are just about there. Translucent, but they have this nice golden tone to them from all that nice bacon fat they're cooking in. So our onions are ready. We're gonna turn this heat down just a smidge, and we're gonna add a tablespoon of flour. But we don't wanna let it brown. We just want it to cook really quickly. Thicken all this up. Right. Flour's coated our onions, and now we're gonna add our reserved clam broth that we have here. With that cooking liquid from when we steamed the clams open. And next we're gonna add our potatoes. This is the time to add your thyme. This is gonna cook for about 10 minutes. Cover it up, and let it all simmer together. Set our timer for 10 minutes. All right, so while our remaining ingredients, the cream, parsley, and reserved bacon are waiting to join this party, we're going to have our highlight, the clam. So we're gonna remove the meat from the shells. If there's any liquid, you do want to try to reserve that. You can add it back in. That's just more flavor, more broth. So we're just gonna give these a little bit of a rough chop, and I'm gonna add them back into the bowl that has some liquid still. All right, so our chowder is almost there. Our potatoes have been simmering for 10 minutes, just a little over. They're soft. They're ready to add our chopped up clams and any remaining liquid. Remember, that's all flavor. And we're not gonna cook this anymore. We just want everything to get hot. So the clams are in, our heavy cream, bacon, and of course, parsley. I'm gonna go for just a minute just to get everything combined and hot and all those flavors hanging out together. So this chowder is not thick and heavy. It's more of that milky broth, which is actually the kind of chowder that I grew up eating. If you like it a little thick and creamier, you just need to make more of a roux base and it'll get that creaminess. But like I said, I like it this way. So this is perfect for me. Make sure I get all that broth. Get some good clams in there. All right. I'm gonna take this over to the table. I'm gonna grab my common crackers and we're gonna taste test. Best part. All right, so it's time for our taste test. I have my common crackers here. I'm gonna grab the one I think looks the best. He's got a nice little golden bit. So these actually are supposed to have that natural sort of equator line or center line to break in half because you are able to eat them either broken up or you can cut them kind of like an English muffin and you can broil them with a little cheese or butter. It's supposed to be really good. I'm gonna try tasting it just on its own. Really nice layers in there. These are beautiful. It's flaky, it's buttery. It's like a little crispy biscuit. It's very tasty. So now I'm gonna try the chowder. Try to get a bite that has a little of everything in it. There we go. I have potato, I have clam, I have bacon, I have parsley. It's the perfect bite. Let's give it a try. Hopefully I don't burn my mouth. Wow. Try a little of just broth. It's really tasty. It's just oceany enough. You can really taste all the elements that are in here. Got clams. The bacon was the first thing I could taste, but then everything else sort of came after it. Bacon sort of has that overpowering flavor sometimes, but I'm trying to get a bite with just clam. It's a little bite. I did a really rough chop, so you have these nice, you can actually tell what you're eating. Really tender, cooked just enough. I've never cooked clams before, so I'm glad they didn't come out terrible. The potatoes, I did have to simmer it a little bit longer to get the potatoes to soften up, but I probably cut them a little too large, just being kind of lazy. If you did a smaller dice, it would have taken maybe 10 minutes or less. So now I'm gonna try to break, is really what you're supposed to do is break up your common cracker. And this is what helps to thicken the chowder. If you like a thicker chowder, this is sort of what they would use. The same way we put oyster crackers, you would crumble one of these. Because they are pretty plain on their own, it's not something, I mean, I would snack on them. I thought they were tasty, but it's not really something you would just eat alone. So let's try. Make sure I get some clam in there. There we go. Just that adds that nice little butteriness. Really, they're soft, but they have a nice little texture to the tooth. All right. I would say overall, the crackers, as challenging as the dough was for me, which it tends to be, they're tasty. I think they came out pretty okay. Maybe not perfect, but all the elements are there. So a little more practice, I would probably get some really nice common crackers. Making the chowder, it was a little daunting. There are a few steps, but nothing overly complicated. It really wasn't that hard. I was a lot more afraid of it because I have never steamed clams, cooked with clams. I don't really do seafood myself. I like restaurants to do that for me, but now that I know how to do it, I'm gonna make this again, kind of a special occasion food, because it's not inexpensive, let's put it that way, but it is worth it and it feeds a pretty good crowd. This is one bowl. This is plenty for me for dinner. There's a ton still on the stove, so you could definitely feed a whole family and more with this recipe. It's delicious. You might as well try it and make a true New England clam chowder. Enjoy.